How's it going, everyone? Today we're here at Overland Expo West in Flagstaff, Arizona, and behind me is a Nismo kitted out Nissan Frontier. So we're gonna take a walk around this as well as this kitted out Xterra and check out some of the new Nismo accessory parts that are coming out. And Carl right here is gonna walk us through all of them. How's it going, Carl?
Great, great. Happy to be here. So
absolutely.
Love to talk to you about our new products.
It's really cool to see all of the stuff that you're adding, because most of the Frontiers that we've been seeing have all been, of course, factory. So there's a bunch of parts that have been added to this one, and these are going to be available from the factory?
Exactly. So not the factory, but from your local Nissan dealer. So we're out here at Overland Expo to announce really our new line of Nismo off-road products. So we know this is a great opportunity. Obviously, you know, there's plenty of people out here in this space. We wanted to provide a factory, you know, a Nissan alternative, if you will, to the aftermarket, so that people can kit out their new Frontiers or their old Frontiers or their Xterras at their local Nissan dealer.
And that way people will know that it's gonna have good fitment, it's going to be well produced, the same quality that you get with the truck originally. So tell me a little bit about this bumper. This is actually a prototype bumper, right?
This is. So the general shape is exactly what we'll be doing with this. But you know, we're gonna make a few little design tweaks here and there, maybe slim it down a little bit, but basically follows the direction with our other bumpers as well, which is, you know, we wanna have a heavy duty off-road bumper that provides some additional protection, recovery points, and on certain vehicles, winch capability. On this one, we've actually made it compatible with the factory collision mitigation systems, intelligent cruise control, and all of that. So, you know, kind of the new thing with the technology on these trucks. What you see in it are our new Nismo off-road lights, our 4-inch round lights here, and then also we have mounts to put them up for, you know, ditch lights, I guess people like to call them. You know, we'll have a variety of lights, these 4-inch, we've got some 6-inch rounds, we've got some 4-inch cubes in our other bumpers as well.
So because this is a prototype bumper, there's no price that's been released on the bumper yet, right?
Correct. We don't have pricing on this. Don't quote me on this. I'm going to say we'll probably be around the $1,000 mark.
Okay.
Our whole pricing strategy for Nismo off-road is to be a competitive alternative to the aftermarket. So, you know, same holds true for things like our tent and other products.
Yeah, and pretty cool to see a Nismo branded tent up there. So we'll check that out in a moment. Are there any extra bits of underbody protection that you guys are adding?
Yeah, so there will be a skid plate that goes along with this bumper that provides some added protection there and is easily removable for access to oil filter and that kind of stuff. And then further down the road, we're looking at some things like rock sliders and, you know, more of that as we go along.
Sweet. Now let's walk around the side and check out these special wheels. This is a much cooler style with this off-road tire than what comes from the factory. It looks more rugged. And what is the pricing on this wheel setup?
So this is our Nismo Axis wheel. This is a 17x7.5, and this is priced at $239. So, you know, really competitive with what's out there in the aftermarket. We've had these on sale since the beginning of the year and are really doing quite well.
And then, of course, like you mentioned, there's some extra off-road lights up here. Are there any switches? How does the wiring work on this? Do you guys offer a wiring harness?
So, yeah, they come with the harness. You know, it's a pretty easy install. I actually wired these up in a couple hours myself.
Nice.
You know, we're trying to integrate switches that fit the factory design as well.
Right.
And then, of course, we offer the brackets, you know, separately.
And then how much is this light kit?
So we haven't finalized the pricing on the 4-inch kits yet, but, you know, we'll probably be right around the $300 point.
Nice. And then you said these are some prototype rock sliders, right?
Yeah, so these are some prototypes. We kind of mocked these up and produced them and really brought them out to the show to kind of gauge feedback and see what people had to say and, you know, where we might go. So some changes on this. We'll probably slim them down a bit.
And then tell me a little bit about this roof rack setup.
Okay, so this is our bed rack. We've got two versions. This one is the high version, and then we also have one that comes to about half the height of this.
Okay.
You know, some people want to put a rooftop tent and not have it stick out above the roof of the truck. So, you know, for better aerodynamics. So we've got two versions of that. It's a modular design. design. So these pieces, the sidebars, can be adjusted and moved into different positions depending upon your needs, or you can remove them. Same with the top cross rails. It's all adjustable, and obviously slots, holes to make it easy to mount things like, you know, your recovery boards or whatever.
And then, is there a difference in price between the mid-height and the high?
There will be a slight difference. Haven't finalized pricing on the low rack yet. That one's in production. High one's about $1,000.
Okay, nice. And then we have to get to this tent up here. So in a moment, I'm actually going to climb up and check out the inside of it. What is the price on this tent?
Pricing on the tent, sorry, again, not finalized. This one's not going to go on sale until the first of the year, but we will be right around the $1,800 mark. So kind of very competitive with similar, soft shell rooftop tents.
Nice, and I'm gonna climb up this ladder and check it out. So you can see, you've got a soft mattress in here. This is a pretty cool setup, very minimal. It looks like it's probably a pretty lightweight setup. Of course, you've got a little bit of the superstructure there, so it just folds over, tucks in to the top of the bed rack. It seems like a pretty nice setup. Do you know round about how much that weighs?
It's less than 100 pounds.
Nice.
It's pretty easy for two people to pick it up, put it on your bed rack. It's got mounting rails, and you know, you don't have to use our rack. Obviously, this will fit on, let's say, if you've got a Nissan Pathfinder with the factory crossbars.
Right.
It'll attach to that. You know, pretty typical design in that regard.
Now,
capacity is 600 pounds.
I know something that is pretty exciting over here is this is a Nismo exhaust. It's got a really nice appearance to it. I like the slash cut. How much is the Nismo exhaust?
So this is not priced yet. Again,
Sorry. No
worries. This is a brand new part for us. It will be right around and everything seems to be around the $1,000 mark, but that's
right.
Pretty much where they come in.
And
this is
pretty typical.
A full cat-back system, all stainless construction. We haven't run the dyno on it yet, but I can tell you we've done back pressure tests, and it's about a 20% reduction in back pressure. Real nice sound to it. Quite popular. We've been selling these for the previous Frontier and Xterra for quite a while now.
Very cool. Could you crank it up? I'd love to hear it.
Yeah, sure.
Looking around, it's got a really nice appearance on this tip. It's almost like it's got a slight copper or bronze color to it. Tucks pretty close to the bottom of the truck, so I don't think there'd be any issues hitting it. Sound to it. I like that bit of crackle that it has. Man, that little crackle sounded good.
Yeah, it's nice on the road. You get some of that nice engine sound, but no droning when you're at highway speed. So it really quiets down at that
point. Yeah, it's decently subtle. And then I see on this side, you've got an axe and you've got a shovel. So a few more accessories mounted on that rack.
Yeah, again, easy way to configure. You can see it from the rack setup. Whatever kind of thing you need to stick on your truck, you can do it.
Now, I know over in your tent here, you've got a display that shows a couple of your suspension components. Tell me a little bit about these. What vehicles are these suspension components made to fit on?
Yeah, so we've partnered with Bilstein, which is one of our OEM suppliers, because we think they make the best products in the market. But these are custom designed for us. These are fitment here. I think these are for the previous generation Frontier.
Okay.
We will have application for both generations Frontier, Xterra. Remote reservoir for added oil capacity and better, you know, cooling under, you
right.
know, rigorous off-road use, bigger piston diameters. And then in the front setup, again, real big shock body, 2.5 inch for extra capacity, improved damping, and higher rate springs for added load of things like bumpers, winches. These are height adjustable. They can go from stock height to up to plus 2 inches. So,
okay.
For example, on the Frontier here, we've got it set up at a 1 inch, you know, to use it like as a leveling kit and
right.
to bring the front end up 1 inch.
Nice. And then I see you've got a few more of your light
these
options.
These are our 6 inch lights. And then this is a bumper for the previous generation 05 to 2021 Frontier. And then, of course, our wheel.
Sweet. Now we have to give a look at this Xterra that you guys kitted out. First things first, this is just an incredibly clean Xterra. I would expect no less from Nissan themselves. They have a really nice Xterra.
Yeah, I love this truck. You know, I think and a lot of people love the Xterra, and we wanted to show some support for the people that have them out there. Really happy with this bumper. Again, super strong recovery points, winch capable. But we made it such that it was really well integrated into the vehicle. We didn't want a whole lot of weight hanging off the front end. I think this is about 105 pounds.
And it doesn't stick out a ton, which I like. No, it's nice and flush.
We worked really hard to get the design to be very sort of, you know, factory look. No cutting of the grill required. If you do put a winch, you got to trim it a little bit. But without the winch, it drops right in.
Is this priced yet?
This will go on sale, and this is also rated at $1,000.
Okay, nice.
It's going on sale in a couple weeks.
Of course, walking around, it looks like the same set of wheels.
Same wheels.
So, of course, the bolt pattern and everything, the fitment is going to be the same on the Xterra as it is on the Frontier.
Exactly. Yep.
And then I see
dedicated light mounts for the Xterra. These actually fit the previous generation Frontier. And also the 05 through 2012 Pathfinder.
And is this priced similarly to the ones that are on the Frontier, about $300?
Same lights.
Nice.
And then around back, we have a heavy-duty bumper for the rear as well. If you tried to go with the real sort of OEM design rather than just a big plate of steel, I've seen a lot of the aftermarket, recovery points and integrated backup lights.
I like the way that it fits within the factory kind of bumper style.
And we need to leave a bit of a gap because you get flex between the body when you're off-roading. Because, of course, the bumper's mounted the frame, your body will flex and move. So.
And then I see another aftermarket exhaust here. Do you mind firing this one up?
Yeah, let me do that.
Sweet. I need to get the key. No worries. A very similar looking exhaust tip on this one, but I love the way that everything is very flush. It doesn't stick out. It doesn't look like it doesn't belong on the vehicle, which is exactly what you would expect from the manufacturer. So these are a couple really cool setups. It's great to see that you guys are supporting communities, not only the ones that are forming with your new vehicles, but also with the communities that have been existing forever with these types of vehicles. And then underneath, any other items that we're missing on there?
Some 2-inch shackles on this to lift it up. So this one, you know, the front suspension was set up 2 inches on this truck. You know, we matched it with some shackles on the rear.
And then your lift kits, is there pricing on those?
Not yet. We're working on that. But I think we're probably right around the $1,200 to $1,400 range for the shock setup and the springs.
Awesome. Well, thank you again for walking us around these vehicles. It's really cool to get to see what Nismo is doing with, again, their current and their past products. And let us know what you guys think in the comments below. We'll see you in the next video.